Hello children, welcome to our EVS class. Our lesson is reproduction in plants. So in the previous class I told about reproduction, seedling, germination and what are the conditions necessary for the germination and what is the structure of a seed. Yes children, so what is reproduction? The process of giving birth to babies to keep up their species on the earth is called a reproduction. So reproduction is also called as a multiplication. Reproduction is also called as a multiplication. Multiplication means more number of plants are grown from the seeds. Yes children, so more number of plants are developed from the seeds. So that is also called as a multiplication. Reproduction is also called as a multiplication. And what is seedling? The small new plant is called a seedling. Germination, the development of a seed into a seedling is called a germination. The development of a seed into a seedling is called a germination. So there are two types of seeds. Means here dicotyledonous seeds and monocotyledonous seeds. So some seeds have two seedlings. So these are seedlings. Actually, if you break the gram seeds, it breaks into two equal halves. Yes children, means some seeds have two seedlings. Okay, so here if you break a seed, it breaks into two equal halves, means there are two seedlings. Okay, what are that? Red gram, black gram, pea, bean, green gram. Okay children, and coriander, daniyalu antam kada avi kuda, maize, rice, wheat. They have only one seedling, that are monocotyledons. Okay children, dicotyledons means the seeds which have two seedlings, that are dicotyledons. Monocotyledons means only one seedling. Okay children, so seed has three parts: seed coat, seedlings and embryo. Seed coat, the outer covering is the seed coat. Okay, and there's a small opening to allow the water to enter inside. Next is seedlings. So seedlings store food. Seedlings store food and they give food for the baby plant. What is the baby plant here? Embryo. So the third part is embryo. It is also called as a baby plant. The baby plant gets its food from seedlings till it gets a pair of leaves. Okay, children. And what are the conditions necessary for the germination? A. Water and sunlight. So in the previous class, I told this activity. Yes, no, no. So do this activity at home also. So for the germination of a seed, all these conditions are necessary. All these conditions are compulsory. If they don't get any one of these, they don't germinate. ఓకే చిల్డ్రన్, ఇది వీటిలో ఏది లేకపోయినా విత్తనాలు మొలకెత్తవు. ఓకే చిల్డ్రన్, ప్లాంట్స్ రిప్రొడ్యూస్ ఇన్ త్రీ వేస్. వాట్ ఆర్ దట్? సీడ్స్, స్పోర్స్, వెజిటేటివ్ ప్రొపగేషన్. సో ఇఫ్ యూ సో ద సీడ్స్ ఇన్ అ సాయిల్, వెన్ ఇట్ గెట్స్ ఏ సఫిషియంట్ ఎయిర్, వాటర్ అండ్ సన్ లైట్, ఇట్ గ్రోస్ ఇన్ ఎ న్యూ బేబీ ప్లాంట్. ఓకే చిల్డ్రన్, నెక్స్ట్. Here the seeds are produced by flowering plants. Means we get fruits from the flowering plants only. Yes, flower changes into a fruit. Fruit has many seeds. So that seed grows into a new baby plant. So flowering plants produce seeds. Means flowering plants reproduce through seeds. Okay children, so many plants reproduce through seeds. Okay, next is spores. Non-flowering plants means they do not have flowers, they don't bear flowers, so they don't have fruits and they don't produce seeds. So non-flowering plants reproduce through spores. So what are the plants? Fern, mosses and fungi. So these plants reproduce through spores. So these spores are very small in size. So these spores are covered in a small box-like structure. These spores are covered in a small box-like structure that is called as the spore box. What is that name? Spore box. Okay, the spores are covered in a small box-like structures that are called as a spore boxes. Okay, so these spore boxes, they burst, means these spore boxes burst and open and spreads spores to different places. Okay, Nana? So when these spore boxes burst and opens, it spreads, means the spores are scattered to different places. Scattered means very general. Okay, spread here. Okay, spread to different places. Okay, children. So when they get suitable conditions, these spores develop into a new baby plant. Okay, children. So these spore boxes are in brown color. These spore boxes are in brown color. So these spore boxes are present underside of the leaf. Means this is upper surface of the leaf and this is lower surface of the leaf. So this is underside. Kindi bhagam kada. So these spore boxes are present underside of the leaf. Okay, children. So they burst open and it spreads its spores to different places. When they get suitable conditions, they grow into a new baby plant. Okay, children. Next, some plants reproduce through vegetative parts. What are the vegetative parts in a plant? What are the vegetative parts, Nana? Root, stem, and leaves. Root, stem, leaves. These are the vegetative parts of a plant. So in some plants, they produce, means these parts give out a new plant. These parts give out a new plant. Okay, children. So here, the vegetative reproduction is much faster than the reproduction through seeds. Okay, children, means through this roots, stems, leaves, the new plants grow very fast. Means seeds we should sow in a soil, and if they get suitable conditions, when they get suitable conditions, they grow as a new baby plant. Yes, children, it takes so much time. A seed takes so much time to grow into a new baby plant. But the new baby plant comes from a root and stem and leaves. It grows very fast. Okay, children, the vegetative propagation is much faster than the reproduction through seeds. Okay, so the plants which reproduce through root, stem, leaves. Okay, children, some plants reproduce through root, stem, and leaves. That process is called a vegetative reproduction or vegetative propagation. Okay, children, see which plants reproduce through roots, which plants reproduce through underground stems, which plants reproduce through stems. Okay, underground stems. Okay, here see first. New plants from roots. Some plants reproduce through roots. Okay, children. New plants from roots. So which roots we eat? Which plant roots we are eating? Beetroot, carrot, sweet potato, turnip. Yes, Nana. So that are the roots. We eat the roots. So from the roots, new plant develops. Okay, children. So take this roots, plant in the soil. Take these roots, keep in the soil. New roots develop from this, means new plant develop from this roots. Okay, children. Next, new plants from underground stems. New plants from underground stems. Here, some plants store their food in a underground stems. What are that? Potato, ginger, onion. Some plants, they store their food in a roots. What are they? Beetroot, carrots, sweet potato, turnip. Yes, children. So if you plant the fruits in the soil, they grow into a new baby plant. Okay, children. Next. So here, potato, onion, ginger. These are the underground stems. Means these plants store their food in the underground stems. Okay. So here, potato, onion. See, potato. So we can observe like this structures on the potato. Yes, no. These are called eyes of potato. These are called eyes of potato. Plant these eyes in the soil. Okay, children. Plant these eyes of the potato in the soil. They grow as a new baby plant. And ginger. Ginger has buds. Ginger has buds. So plant this ginger in the soil. They grow as a new baby plant. Next, onion. Onion, it is also called as a bulb. Why? It is like a bulb. It is like a bulb. See here, roots. And these are onion leaves. Okay, children. Means these are all grow in the inside the ground. Okay, children. So these are underground stems. These are underground stems. Bhoomi lopala perugutayi kada ivi. Potato, onion, ginger anevi. Yes, no. So these are the underground stems. Means stems are modified into a fruit or a vegetable. Okay, children. So modified stems and anevi. So here, onion. It is also called as a bulb. Why? This look like a bulb. Okay, children. If you plant this bulb in the soil, it grows as a new baby plant. Next, new plants from runners. New plants from runners. Examples: mint and grass. So mint means pudina. So grass plant. So mint and grass. These plants stems are very weak. These plant stems are very weak. So they creep along the ground. They creep along the ground. So these plants, these stems have. These plant stems have nodes. Nodes means kanupulu. ఇలా ఉంటాయి కదమ్మా కనుపులు. సో ద స్టెమ్స్ హ్యావ్ నోడ్స్. న్యూ రూట్స్ డెవలప్ ఎట్ ద నోడ్స్. న్యూ రూట్స్ డెవలప్ ఎట్ ద నోడ్స్. ఓకే చిల్డ్రన్, హియర్ దీస్ ప్లాంట్స్ సో వెరీ వీక్. దీస్ ప్లాంట్ దీస్ గ్రాస్ ప్లాంట్స్ అండ్ మిన్ ప్లాంట్స్ ఆర్ వెరీ వీక్. సో దే క్రీప్ ద స్టెమ్స్ ఆఫ్ దీస్ గ్రాస్ ప్లాంట్స్ క్రీప్ అలాంగ్ ద గ్రౌండ్. The stems of mint and grass plants creep along the ground and they crop kuntu pote. Yes, no. So when these are creeping along the ground, new roots develop at the nodes of the stems of grass and mint plants. Okay, children. Here, so these new plants separate from the plant and it grows as a new baby plant. Okay, children. So here, these plants, they look as they are running on the ground. So that's why these are called as a runners. That's why these are called as a runners. Okay, children. And next one, new plants from stem cuttings. New plants from stem cuttings. So here, examples: rose, sugarcane, hibiscus. So in our houses, so our mothers, what they do? They bring the stem cuttings of rose and hibiscus from other houses, from other's house, and they plant that stem in the soil. Yes, Nana. So here, through stems also, new plants develop. New plants develop means new plants develop from a stems. Stems of some plants. So if we take one stem of rose or hibiscus. Rose or hibiscus with the buds and nodes. And nodes. Nodes means kanupulu. Okay, children. So take the stem cutting of plants with the buds and plant that stem cutting in the soil. And that grow as a new baby plant. That grow as a new baby plant. Okay, children. So here, how can we know the roots are developed to the stem inside the soil? Means If we see the rising of new leaves to the stem, if we see the rising of new leaves from the stem cutting, then we can understand the roots are developed to the stem in the soil. Means that is alive. That is alive. పచ్చిగా ఉంటే అది అలైవ్ గా ఉంటుంది. మళ్ళీ మనం ఈ చిన్న చిన్నగా ఆకులు వస్తుంటాయి కదా, అవి గమనిస్తే మనకేం అర్థమవుతుంది, రూట్స్ వచ్చాయని అర్థమవుతుంది. ఓకే చిల్డ్రన్, మీన్స్ ఇఫ్ ఇట్ ఈస్ డ్రైడ్, ఇఫ్ ఇట్ ఈస్ డ్రైడ్ మొత్తం ఎండిపోయింది అనుకో, అది చచ్చిపోయింది ఇంకా. దట్ విల్ నాట్ గ్రో యాజ్ అ న్యూ బేబీ ప్లాంట్. ఇఫ్ ఇట్ ఈస్ టెండర్ పచ్చిగా ఉంటే అది కొత్త మొక్కగా పెరుగుతుంది. ఓకే చిల్డ్రన్, నెక్స్ట్. So here, in this grafting is another method. Grafting is another method. By grafting method, we can get two types of flowers and two types of fruits on one plant. Means by attaching, when stem cuttings are attached to the shoot of other plant, when stem cuttings are attached to the shoot of another plant, okay children, so this is called as a grafting method. This is called as a grafting. So take one sweet mango stem cutting and sour mango tree. Sour mango tree. Okay children, now attach the stem cutting of sweet mango. Attach the stem cutting of sweet mango to the shoot of sour mango tree. Shoot of sour mango tree. So which fruits do we get? Sour or sweet? Sweet fruits, sweet mango fruits we get from this sour mango tree. Okay children, when we attach the stem cutting of sweet mango to the sour mango tree, to the stem of sour mango tree, we get the sweet mango fruits. Okay children, did you understand? So now here take pink color rose flower plant. Attach the stem cutting of red rose flower. Okay children, attach the stem cutting of red rose flower to the shoot of pink color rose flower plant. Then we get two types of flowers on one plant. Okay children, so like this means by the grafting method we get the two types of fruits and two types of flowers on one plant. Okay children, did you understand this? Yes. Stem one means sweet. By this method we can understand means one plant is very weak but we are getting more fruits. But one plant is very strong but it is giving only few fruits. Then by the stem cutting method we can develop a plant with so many fruits, means which is very weak and giving more fruits. Take the stem cutting of that plant and attach the stem cutting to the strong plant. Attach the strong plant. So for example, this is very strong plant and giving less fruits. less fruits. And another one is very weak but giving more fruits. So take this stem cutting and attach to this plant. Attach to this plant. Okay, then we get the more fruits from the plant, from the strong plant. Okay, children. So like this also we can do by the grafting method. Okay, children. Next, new plants from layers. New plants from layers. So jasmine and raspberries. Jasmine and raspberries. So here, this jasmine and raspberries have so many branches. So many branches, and these branches are very close to the earth. Very close to the earth. So here, so take one branch. Take one branch. Okay, and bend towards the earth surface. Bend towards the earth surface and cover with the moist soil. Cover with the moist soil. And after few days, new roots develop from that place. And separate that new plant from the mother plant and plant in a another place. Plant in a another new place and it grows as a new baby plant. Okay, children. So jasmine and raspberries, they reproduce through layers. Means new plants develop from the layers. Okay, children. Next, new plants from leaves. So bryophyllum and begonia. So these plants reproduce through leaves. So means, so these plants have leaves, and on the leaves they have buds now. So these plants leaves have buds. Okay, so new baby plant grows from a each bud. Okay, children. So here, are you seeing here? Small new plant from the leaves. Yes. So these leaves fall, when they fall on the ground, when they get suitable conditions, these buds develop into a new baby plant. After growing, it separates from the leaf and it grows as another plant. Okay, children, are you observing here? See, these are attached to the leaves only. So here, these are buds. Are you seeing brown color spots at the corners like this? Okay, so that are buds. Okay, children. So in a bryophyllum and begonia, leaves bear means they have buds, and from each bud, new baby plant grows. Okay, children. So new baby plant grows from each bud of these leaves. Okay, did you understand up to here? Okay, some plants, they reproduce through roots, leaves and stems. So which plants? Some plants reproduce through roots, stems, leaves. That is called as a vegetative propagation or vegetative reproduction, or it is also called as a asexual reproduction. So some plants reproduce through seeds. That is sexual reproduction. That is sexual reproduction. Okay, children. Good.